The apparition of these faces in the crowd, petals on a wet black bough. Ezra Pound, deaf poet. Let's get it going.
I got a story to tell. Ideas kiss similes so deeply.
Deaf poetry.
Your existence is fractionally status quo.
I just got my wings.
And I was searching.
My people's in the house.
Watch the empty pursuit of pride.
Pharmaceutical schemes. Somebody got to hear my story.
Give it up, give it up, give it up.
Russell Simmons presents Deaf Poetry.
New York City, please make some noise for Deaf Poetry and your host, Mos Def.
What's up, New York? We come tonight as voices united with joy, purpose, sometimes pain. We're here to rock your world and give you something to talk about. Welcome to Deaf Poetry. Is y'all ready for some poetry, motherfucker? Our next guest is, I saw him recently in Brooklyn, and I have not seen many people move a crowd the way that this brother moves a crowd. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm Deaf Poetry welcome for my man, Mr. Wyclef Jean. As you look at me, your mind start to wander. You say to your face, I look familiar. Yeah, you do know me, but it's not from your TV. I'll give you a clue, 1983. Yes, I was the kid in class, the little Haitian one with the accent. You came over to me and you said, yo, I don't know why they let you cross the border. You know you got HBO, man. You know you got HBO. I said to him, what do HBO mean? He told me HBO mean Haitian body odor. Oh, man. And I tell you, man, just before I could think and blink, the African-American girl sitting next to me said, you know you Haitian and you stink and you got AIDS and you need to go back to your country. I tell her, it's funny that you should say that because this is not even your country. And no, AIDS did not come from Haiti, Mrs. Stella. Why are you over here making a joke about it? The virus is spreading to the Caribbean and throughout Africa. You still don't remember me. You, yeah. Flatbush Avenue, you tried to take my sneakers. But you know I'm from the project, so when you come attack me, I do dragon style on you. Yeah. But you look at me and you say, you fool. Kung fu don't work with gun fu. Take off your sneakers. So there I take off my sneakers, but man, I was pissed. Boy, I tell you, man. You, man, I tell you, man. Boy, I was pissed, man. I wanted to kill you, man. I wanted to kill you. But not because you robbed me, but you see, my father worked 3 jobs, and I begged him to get me a pair of sneakers, and then I get robbed. You know, my father's a minister, and he said, vengeance is for the Lord. So that night, I come back with a Tech 9. Not only did I get my sneakers back, I robbed the whole block for all the shine. And here comes the sirens, handcuffs, but too young for Rikers Island. But there I sat at the juvenile home. A little boy was sitting next to me. I said, what are you reading? He said, it's the history of Haiti. I said, read some to me. He said, in 1804, Haiti was the first black country to get its independence, man. So I say to you, when my spirit leaves my flesh, let my tombstone, let it carve, man, the life of a refugee. To live for yourself is to live selfishly, but to live for others is to live eternally. And I, Wyclef Jean, live for all of humanity. So, Mr. Bushy, if you're watching this, I know you're trying to get rid of another tax cut, but Haiti can use some more money. Yeah. Thank you.
please give it up for 18-year-old Nylee Adore-Dore Kamuchi.
A brand new Rockaware suit, $180. Air Force Ones, $120. MAC makeup, $60. A glance from someone? Priceless. Wait a minute. Man, I just paid $360 for that glance, and now you're telling me it's priceless. Hell no. Tags are running on my back, and I'm bending over backwards trying to attract that glance into steady time leaps. Priceless? I covered my face trying to win first place, only instead of getting a trophy, I was one. Paying $360 for hollas that only talk to your back, yet you're still bending over backwards trying to attract that glance into steady time leaps. Priceless? Flat broke. So now my master is the card, but that whipped me with false promises. And the drama is minimal payments keep getting tainted with more mini malls meant to pay for that priceless glance. And it's more than just under my skin, it's under my $50 pants. Tried to ask my master to forget my piling up debt, but what's done is done. Now I can only consolidate my self-worth into price tags. Looking out for sales to find 50% off my self-worth. Looking into eyes, the penetrating into eyes, but seeing nothing. I'm seeing nothing. A penny saved did not rescue me from spending $360. Rockaware hit rock bottom. Air Force Ones had a crash landing and MAC makeup maxed out. I am here, bending over backwards, bending over on my back in the beds of materialism. It was only a one-night stand, but was enough for me to give birth to something I don't even recognize. A lost reflection, clear and tasteless. I am becoming my tears. I'm not fitted to run with the fittest. I am not faceless, just two-faced, lessening my chances of winning the race. I need 50% off my self-worth, so it hurts minimally when that mini ball breaks my back, because eventually bending over backwards will snap me in two. Right then, I will have half of a reflection and 50% off my soul. A brand new rock bottom debt, $180. A crash landing, $120. Being maxed out, $60. A glance of false promises, priceless.
From Cranston, Rhode Island, all the way to Brooklyn, New York, please give a warm good welcome to Michael Cirelli.
All right, this one goes out to the one who got away. You might know her. It's called Love Song for Khalees. I can't compare your voice to Sarah Vaughan's sassy tabernacle, or to Ella's frantic sidestep up a fire escape on a sticky night in Harlem, not even to the impenetrable vaults in Holiday's lungs, or Nina Simone's sad peach with the crew cut. Your voice is not hash smoke swirling around an antique fan in Amsterdam, or the strong finger of bourbon on my chest, or Tina Turner's electric hairdo. It may be simply the best, baby, but it is still nothing like Chaka Khan's bottom lip after lovemaking. I can see how some might think that your voice is a milky cherry drowning on the bottom of a chocolate shake, or that holding your CD next to my face in front of the mirror is the picture of a perfect couple. And I know your husband's father is a horn player, but my dad is a cook. He rings bells when eggs are hot. I will use this against you if ever I get a chance. I know your voice is sugar, honey, iced tea with a striped straw. And though I may never get a sip, even so, it still makes my body go, yeah, yeah.
Chicago, please give it up for M-Rel.
Ready for love, standing here steady for love, but love just can't seem to find me. When I think Cupid's arrow was pointing my way, it hits the person behind me. See, I think Cupid is blind, see. Then you came along. No more Toni Braxton's another sad love song. No more lonely nights or weekends. He's always there when I need him. A smile so bright every time he part his lips, he could cause an eclipse. His kisses are sweeter than triple chocolate fudge with a cherry on top. I tell you, this man I got, he never disrespects me. He just lets me be me. And when we beef, I tell him to put the BS beneath this. I want to carry his feet, just wash his feet like Jesus, because like Lazarus, he brought me back from the dead. I could never deny him or verbally crucify him. I just want to be by him. In every sense of the word, I need him. No need checking my DNA. I bleed him. Turn me into Stevie Wonder and I'll still see him. Cut off my oxygen and I'll still breathe him. I just gotta be near him. Make me deaf and dumb and I'll still hear him. In love I gave up and had no luck, and just like Humpty Dumpty, I fell off that great wall, now I'm all broke up. When I mention his name, I get all choked up and tongue twisted. To him I am addicted. I need Oxycontin or methadone. He is the king and I am the queen upon his throne. And when we are in the king's quarters, I follow all the king's orders. Like coming to America's Prince Hakeem, I make sure his royal penis is clean, and he sure know how to make his soul glow. He my black Russell Crowe. He a gladiator and he got a beautiful mind. Even when he on the grind, he finds time to drop his baby a dime just to ask, how was my day? And am I okay? And that's what makes me love you so much more. Let's stay together. There's so much more in store. God must have heard my prayers when I sent them above. I'm so happy I was ready and prepared for love.
Give it up for M. Wells, yo. Very glad to be here doing Deaf Poetry. It's amazing. I think the show's incredible. Everybody's dressed, nobody's singing. It's a hit show. Chicago, please give it up for Red Storm.
Y'all remember that fight to be president? Back in 2000 for that White House resident? That shit was irrelevant. They spent $30 million on the election, had starving families out here fighting for a collection just to feed their young. The whole world watched TV to see who won, because the media was at the White House, but it wasn't the right house. When niggas was struggling, putting food in their mouths and clothes on their backs. Instead, you put billions into the military to fund another attack. So you tell me, man, where your motherfucking humanity at? The red, white, and blue, they gonna get your votes and turn their backs on you. Is this the American dream? Where babies starving, too hungry to scream. Black streets filled with crack. Police locking anybody up who even look black, like, we the problem. We just they scapegoats, so they ain't gotta solve them. See, they building more prisons instead of schools. They passing more laws and making more rules. I don't know about y'all, but I ain't gonna keep being they fool. Why? Why kids so lost and hooked on reefer? Because the state refused to pay good teachers, but see, that's their plan. They need to let all us know. Is that why so many innocent niggas wind up on death row? I don't think the president really cares. But when it's time to vote, he want us all there to believe in this bullshit sales pitch, get the bitch in office, and then he forget and wonder why crime exists. Niggas tired, can't take it no more. Tired of the rich getting rich and the poor getting poor. CNN, still trying to figure out who won that race, but that shit don't matter. They still gonna spit in our face, and the ghetto still gonna be a forgotten place full of hate. Straighten it out, people.
In Chicago, please give a warm round of applause. Get inside.
The week the tsunami hit, I started reading the Bible again for the first time since I was 5 years old. Right. God and all of his double dealing and covenants, pimping out Sarah, setting up Eve. Believe me, God will cut you down to size. So maybe it was him striking his fist into the earth and rolling back the waves, that rude, reckless, unrelenting morning. I open the morning paper to see the newspaper talk about its colorful graphs and technical explanations of earthquakes and aftershocks. And all I could think is that every little thing has to do with each other. So cried CNN, Reuters, the Associated Press, and the BBC. So cried the Red Cross and all the war hawk countries, glaring at each other to loosen their purse strings, to up the ante. I turn on the radio, and there's so much laughter. The mouths are huge, monstrous, as prayers and exhausted sighs of relief sound with every phone call, every family member. I'm alive. I survived. I can hear you. A sober vision as I close Bible pages, pick it up by the spine, and throw it against the wall. It breaks open, leaves trembling like lips. I don't understand you, God, but I do understand it's not your fault.
Thank you. In Chicago, please give a warm death poetry welcome to Paul Mabon.
It started with a toothbrush. I thought we were just friends. But something told me I should have known she was trying to move in. Monday, she leaves the toothbrush. Tuesday, is that her jacket? Wednesday, she leaves the makeup so I can get used to looking at it. Thursday, lingerie in my sock drawer space. Friday, I found her stuff all over the place. It was blow dryers, curling irons, fake nails, earrings. Is this your hair in my razor? Is it over? Is it over? Hell no, it ain't over. Because this ain't how I used to live. And when she come in here tonight, I'm gonna tell her what it is. Hey, baby, how you doing? See, baby, it's a few things that you fail to understand. Now, I love you too, but... Oh, shoot. Damn! I used to kick it with my boys, dog. Remember them HBO fights? Now it's crab legs and Red Lobster every Friday night. It's not funny. I used to buy clothes and spend money without even sharing the wealth. Now I get up in the morning, can't even dress myself. Baby, did you say the blue tie? Okay, I'll let you see. Well, yeah, I get off work late sometime. That's a problem, I agree. Well, yeah, I like spending time with you. Girl, I know you like spending time with me. Well, baby, what you trying to say? What do you need? My house keys? No, my keys! No, not my keys! On behalf of all the single committed men, I am not giving you my keys. I don't care how long it's been. Now look, I love you too. Ooh, I just said it again. What you trying to do to me, baby? We used to be friends. Now first you leave your toothbrush. These are my keys. Now look, I'm a man. Now what's left for me? Nothing. Nothing. You will compromise from day one to the last until it finally dawns on you. Girl, I do love your ass. And it started with a what?
Please welcome from Chicago, Mr. Kevin Derrick.
This piece is dedicated to my cousin Andrew. His bandaged face, the face of a pointless war. Hospital bed moves a couple times an hour to prevent him from getting bed sores. He'll be fit for a glass eye tomorrow. And they said his left hand might be able to be saved. His father was a Marine. So was his uncle's memory. Finalized in Vietnam jungles, glorified in the marble of a memorial. He's gotta make this country proud. Doing so the only way he knows how. Tightly laced combat boots, a matching M16. Gonna protect freedom, but doesn't know what that means. Confused by Pentagon Podium's propaganda, painting Becca red, white, and blue. Taking turbans like scalps, cause he hasn't lost faith in the stars and stripes that wrap around his thin 19-year-old arms. But this freedom has been compromised by U.S. footprints trampling the homes of Iraqi children who also believe the boogeyman exists, except not under beds and over rooftops, as Andrew marches through Baghdad streets, individuality engraved in dog tags. Just a 19-year-old kid trying to straighten out his life, now tangled in the sounds of explosions, the buck-bucks of AKs aimed right at him. He doesn't know why he wants to kill him. He doesn't know why they want him dead, but he's a Marine. He's got to protect our freedom to get rich off the weak, our freedom to pay 50 fucking cents cheaper at the gas pump. He misses home. Feels the only way there is through Iraqi lives. Buck, buck the few. Buck, buck the proud. Buck, buck the Marines. Buck, buck. When the explosion went off, they said he was lucky. Most of the shrapnel hit his lower body, only took an eye and half his face. He'll be fit for a glass eye tomorrow, and they said his left hand might be able to be saved. Sore throat claims fluent speech as he struggles to ask his family if we're still proud. And we just want to know if he still looks like Andrew.
From San Jose, California, please give it up for Mr. Mike McGee.
Y'all felt this before, I know you have. Man, I like you. I like you like blue whales like to say, I like you a whole bunch of a lot. You're a pocket full of awesome. I like you similar to the way pirates and frat boys like booty. Like David Copperfield likes performing grand scale yet lame-ass feats of illusion. Like the US government likes performing grand scale yet lame-ass feats of illusion. Like testicles and homeboys like to hang. Like homeless people and breakdancers like cardboard. Like Muppets like fisting. I like... You all act like you've never seen a happy Muppet. I like you a whole bunch of a lot and a whole lot more times infinity. And maybe that's starting to dip into the equation of love. Nevertheless, I got a thing for you. Like magnets got it for refrigerators. I'm stuck on you. And I like it. I like you an official metric fuckload. I think you're a body full of soul, and I hope you like me back. And I guess I'm just tired of meeting people who define themselves by what they don't like. I just don't like that. But I do like holding you, the way your pillow holds your head when you sleep, the way gay, lesbian, transgender, transsexual, Irish, and Mexican people hold parades. The way the earth holds the moon and the sun holds the earth and how they'll constantly spin around each other forever. And even though that metaphor doesn't really make sense with regard to this poem, because that would imply that there were three of us, which would also be awesome. But you get the idea. In my book, you rock and I like rocks. What the fuck? Anyhow, just because I spent an hour or so writing this down doesn't mean you have to like me back. But damn it, I would really like that.
From Trenton, New Jersey, please give it up for Nirubi Salah.
Southern boy up north, still about 3/5 respected even by himself. 3-piece pinstripe, leather belt, hat tip, 90 degrees. Cufflinks, tailor-made, initials laid, BS. Mr. Big Shot or Mr. Bullshit or Mr. Black Sucker, but still most won't deny. The flip side still verbatim. Loose denim, venom style, small gold decadent, a pinky ring of course. Sipping whites only lemonade under the flimsy shade on the porch. The source spilling residues of slave-made guillotines cooperating to remain coexistent, jolted nonetheless. While fatty girls head first, dead last swing upright from right bright timberland trees. The proof is in your royalties, mailed into your ghetto, spent on amaretto. Toddler-sized handguns, white bulletproof strollers, black bulletproof soldiers, mad farms milled and still sucked of natural resource, but thin as in, of course. And Coltrane is overlooked. And rap concerts are overbooked. And 40 ounces are now found in the same aisle as the grits. Checked out by dropouts that now check out hits. And beats your broken heart eating gumbo on a porch. Salon-made redheads, picture perfect in the bins. A picture perfect Uncle Ben's. Willie Lynch blueprint laid across the dash. A bamboozled airbag anticipating the driver's crash. Peace.
From Oakland, California, please give a warm death poetry welcome to Ice Life.
How my people go from fighting for freedom to acting dumb for free? See, back in the days, we were slaves, whips and chains. Now we think it's tradition, all we care about is driving whips and having chains. These weak-ass rappers carry more junk than city dumps and trucks. No pink mohawk, spiked leather coats, but still they punk. Spreading that junk like germs. Your little girl 9, she can't read, but she could cuss, and we act like we don't know what she learned. But we know how it all start. Listening to these rappers so pop that they flow is taught. Women showing so much ass in the videos, you can see their farts. Before they happen. And the whole time we in the club smiling and laughing, writing the words like we wrote this shit laughing and dancing. Smack a bitch, kill a hoe, you know, fuck niggas, kill bitches, get paid, I'm a slave. And I love it. I know what I'm doing is wrong, but fuck it. It's my birthday. I'ma celebrate. Get stupid. Get ignorant. Get so high and drunk in the morning, I won't remember it. Sometimes I wonder. I wonder if we ever gonna get it right. When we get that, we gotta run away from lies and run towards the truth. We always running towards some dumb shit. I got proof. Observe the ignorant Olympics. See us run up the phone bill talking about nothing, but we giving the phone company everything. Then we ride to the auto lot, ride to the dope spot. Watch us run poison through our veins. Watch us make $100 and spend 99 on a chain. Yeah. And yes, the media and the government are to blame, partially. Because the government gives us the state, which gives us the police that say, steal that chain, nigger. I'ma take you to jail, nigger. Smack that woman, nigger. I'ma take you to jail, nigger. Sell drugs, nigger. I'ma take you to jail, nigger. And kill somebody, nigger. And watch how smooth take your ass to jail, nigger. And then the media give us videos that say, get that chain, nigger. Smack that bitch, nigger. Make sure you say bitch when you do that shit, nigger. And oh, nigga, sell drugs, nigger, because you got to be a thug, nigger. How you going to be a thug, nigger, without them drugs, nigger? Nigger, and oh, nigga, kill other niggas, because they ain't known you, nigger. But I love you, nigger. That's why I show you pimping and clothes and hoes, because you my nigger. I mean, nigger. And we buy into the madness, and our situation gets deeper. The trick is the media and the government are both ran by the same people. Thank you.
Give it up for Ice Life, y'all. I got a poem. I mean, like, yeah, I write poems. Nobody believes in me now. Okay, I got a poem before we go. It's the world's shortest poem written by Muhammad Ali. Y'all wanna hear it?
Yeah.
Me, we. Give it up for Russell Simmons, y'all. Say something.
I want to say something about Wyclef Jean. We just lost a very important brother in Ozzie Davis. He's a person who used his celebrity to benefit everyone else, his entire career. And there's no fighter for our freedom, no greater in the industry than this man here. Just a soldier. A soldier. Thank y'all for coming out. God bless.
Why speak of the use of poetry? Poetry is what uses us. Hayden Carruth, Deaf Poet. Let's get it going.
I got a story to tell, ideas, kiss similes so deeply.
Deaf poetry.
Your existence is fresh, you got us quo.
I just got my wings.
And I was searching.
My people's in the house.
Watch the empty pursuit of prize.
Pharmaceutical.
Somebody
got to hear my story.
Give it up, give it up, give it up.
Russell Simmons presents Deaf Poetry.
Ladies and gentlemen, your host from the planet of Brooklyn, Mos Def.
Yeah. What up, New York? What's good? How y'all doing? Oh, it's very good to be here. Very, very nice. Thank y'all for continuing to support the show and come out. For real. Okay. I'm just a big fan of this cat, man. A big supporter. And I'm glad to see his success. It's totally deserved. And it's a great pleasure to have him here again. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for my man, Kanye West.
You know how people come out to poetry slams and they light incense and everything. I had to make my own ambiance, you know, for me to feel comfortable. It really don't have nothing to do with the poem whatsoever. I just thought it looked good on TV, so. People always talk about, you know, Kanye, is he really like that? Is he really that arrogant? I just don't like his attitude. I don't like, you know, they say your attitude determines your latitude. Well, I'm high as a motherfucker, fly as a motherfucker. And still the motherfucker you love to hate, but can't, because you love what I make. Now, ain't that about a bitch? And I'ma talk shit until I'm out of hits. They don't wanna turn the speakers up, they claim I ain't deep enough. All that talking I feed off of, keep it up. I'm relaxing, my feet is up. I'm leaving you haters like when Shaq left the Lakers just to heat it up. I state the stats to stunt. I don't need the front. Make black history a day. I don't need a month. The survey says by the streets according, Kanye just important as Michael Jordan was to the NBA when he was scoring. Ralph Lauren was boring before I wore him. Okay, so we get to the real poems now. I just want to stop real quick. This is about, you know, something I've been through in the past year that I'm sure a lot of y'all have been through, and y'all will get the gist of it at the poem, as the poem goes on. It's called Bittersweet. Bittersweet, you're gonna be the death of me. I don't want you, but I need you. I love you and hate you at the very same time. See, what I want so much should never hurt this bad. Never did this before. That's what the virgin says. We've been generally warned. That's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now. This is an emergency. And she claims she only with me for the currency. You cut me deep, bitch. Cut me like surgery. And I was too proud to admit that it was hurting me. I never do that to you, at least purposely. We breaking up again, we making up again, but we don't love no more, I guess we fucking then. Have you ever felt you ever want to kill her? And you mix them emotions with tequila. And you mix that with a little bad advice. On one of them bad nights, you have a bad fight. And you talking about her family, her aunts and shit. And she say, motherfucker, your mama's a bitch, you know. Domestic drama and shit, all the attitude. I never hit a girl, but I shake the shit out of you. But I'ma be the bigger man, big pimping like Jigga Man. Oh, I guess I figure it's bittersweet. You're gonna be the death of me. I don't want you, but I need you. I love you and hate you at the very same time. See, what I want so much should never hurt this bad. Never did this before. That's what the virgin says. We've been generally warned. That's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now. This is an emergency. And my nigga said I shouldn't let it worry me. I need to focus on the girls we getting currently. But I've been thinking and it got me back to sinking in. This relationship, it even got me back to drinking. Now this Hennessy is gonna be the death of me. And I always thought that you having my child was our destiny. But I can't even vibe with you sexually. Cause every time that I try, you will question me, saying you fucking them girls, disrespecting me. You don't see how your lies is affecting me. You don't see how life was supposed to be. And I never let a nigga get that close to me. And you ain't cracked up to what you was supposed to be. You always gone, you always be where them hoes to be. And it's the first time she ever spilled a soul to me. I fucked up and I know it, G. I guess it's bittersweet poetry.
From Philadelphia, please give it up for the fantastic Ursula Rucker.
Until you walk, run, fight, a mile in her shoes, don't you dare stand in front of me and tell me what a woman must do. She must swing from chandeliers for undeserving spouses and paramours who deny her suffrage by day but crave and praise her womanly wiles by night. Good enough to fuck, but not good enough to vote. She must go from the beauty of Africa to the horrors of Massa, go from titties dangling bare and shameless to being branded licentious, temptress, embarrassed, go from land of yams and heat hot to land of cash crops and seller's block, go from God names to no name to his names, now black, now inhuman, freedom stolen, family stolen, now beholden but still golden, field hollering, and ain't I a woman, and ain't I a woman, what a woman must do. She must wipe away tears and reclaim strength after rape, abortion, lover's betrayal, husband's abuse, tricking to buy baby shoes. She must be called a muse, which is just a synonym for use. Put upon pedestals, dainty and protected, and because of that disrespected, Victorianized, victimized, made a paradox of famous anonymity, left to go insane with too much femininity, staring at the yellow wallpaper, her heart open, her legs open, warm and welcoming, waiting for phone calls that never come, waiting for words of appreciation that never come, waiting for equal pay that never comes, it just never comes, waiting, waiting for love, waiting for acknowledgement, not judgment, waiting. And when seeking or achieving any place of power, reduced to labels like concubine, cunt, bitch, whore, stunt, witch, dyke, and none of those are her name, and none of those have ever been her name, your name or my name. What a woman must do until you walk, run, fight, just 1 mile in her shoes. Don't you even dare stand in front of me and tell me what a woman must do.
From Berkeley, California, please give up for 19-year-old Rafael Casal.
Sometimes I feel like I'm sitting in the back of Barbie and Ken 101, a class we're all in but never seem to learn from. Some general ed requirement for students of American culture. One that convinces even the brightest of young women that sex is survival of the thinnest, and I'm sick of this education that doesn't serve our best interest. My teacher has no face. She is every Revlon model women have ever chased. Her lectures can be seen in the backs of magazines, beauty ads, and marketing campaigns. Shit, just turn on your TV. This just in, a skewed perspective for today's youth. Y'all ladies ain't thin enough, fellas ain't trim enough. Wanna be sexy, y'all don't go to the gym enough. Cut to commercial. Come on. Just tune into their maintenance team. Tell you you're ugly, then tell you how to fix it with Maybelline. Please, they just molding Barbie to fit the new trend. Next, they're gonna have club hopping Barbie with thongs as accessories. Video hoe Barbie, abusive boyfriend sold separately. Underage Barbie, Kobe Bryant's included. On 9/11, victim Barbie and Ken is proud to get recruited. Problem is, all these teachings are women's decay, and my girlfriend is sitting up front, and she's getting an A. This is where I start getting really pissed off, okay? When the fuck did it become about tucking in a gut? I gotta get the bigger breast. Shit, I wanna fit a little better in a dress. So let me get a little skinny, gotta fit into an itty bitty size slimmer just to liven up the chest. Please, teacher, I wanna give my oral presentation, cause I have a problem with the class. As a matter of fact, I have a damn problem with your whole administration. You're the reason my girl won't sit across from me in restaurants. The reason that she thinks she's over fat and over 10 spots. Less gut, less pudge, less looks, less real, more looks, more love, more Barbie appeal. Oh shit, fuck Barbie and Ken. They're the reason 15-year-old girls girl's arms are slit. The reason 12-year-olds think skinny is a compliment. And it's too late. It is too late. I can't ride my way through these bathroom doors. So I raise my hand in class because I can't take it anymore. Teacher, teacher, your lectures are all backwards. You got mothers and daughters forgetting what matters. Because above hips, ass, lips, legs, and Uggs, the most real ass shit is women who don't give a fuck. So screw all your teachings. So screw all your teachings, your lessons and plans, you skewed, sick, distant relative of the man. Your plan for brainwashing my baby, I reject. I'm walking out of your class and I will proudly take my F.
From Charlotte, North Carolina, please give a warm, good course you welcome to Terry Creech.
If I could be anything in the whole world, the thing I would most like to be is a penguin. For no other reason than they always like they're dressed up and they're going somewhere fancy. You know, like that Glacier Club where you can find them dancing or swimming or flapping their beaks with every other penguin they meet, because those little birds can socialize. And you can see it in their eyes when they look to the skies and they think, man, I wonder what it'd be like to soar up there and drop a surprise from between my thighs on top of the head of a polar bear. Sounds like fun. The problem is that penguins can't fly, so I know I couldn't be one, because I need to be up there, tickling the bottom of the clouds with my fingers, trying to make the entire sky shed tears of laughter, just so that me and my kin will never feel lonely again. This is the job of a lost bird. The name given to adopted Native American children whose parents paid their rent by signing peace treaties with the government and praying that their kids can make red and white Knicks. I am a lost bird too, leading V formations and giving rides to butterflies, because we know what it feels like to have your wings torn away from you by the strength of laughter. We are prodigal children with no homes to return to, members of a church where there are no pews and a preacher only speaks in the number of years you've been flying. Throwing torturous noises into the air like bombs over Baghdad, we ride them like slingshots, throwing us back into the sky, hoping to cast the last shadow of hopeless redemption. And now, it's not just Native American children, y'all. We're all a generation of lost birds, fulfilling the fears of our forefathers in the places where they came to know them, leaving us to suffer through skies of malice filled with fiberglass clouds where love has just as much use as peanut butter. But we will know that despite the colors that grace all of our wings, they all look red when pressed against the horizon. And that somehow through it all, our feathers were filled with purpose. And no matter how many miles pass beneath us, nor how many tree limbs taste our talons, there will always be a good day to die. Just like there will always be a good day to fly.
From Minneapolis, Minnesota, please give a warm welcome to Phaedra Sheridan.
At 3 o'clock in the morning, he's pounding on my door with a liter of gin in his bloodstream and $30 worth of White Castle hamburgers in case I'm hungry. This isn't as bad as when he belts Ricky Martin with feeling for his best friend who died in a mob-related incident I suspect is either not dead or never existed. I trust him so implicitly, I wrote down the serial numbers to all my stereo components before he moved in. Listen, you want to spend your time registering for online dating services? You do what you gotta do. But I need another boyfriend? Like, I need to exfoliate with a cheese grater. I cannot be trusted. You show me 50 handsome, responsible, upstanding men and one loveless, self-absorbed creep, I'll take the creep every time. I like a mean and inconsiderate. The kind of guy who hides guns in my hall closet. Find me the most despicable, insensitive, compulsive, fucked up asshole in any given room. That's my sweetie. Does this sound bitter? Why don't you wait unwittingly in the car while your boyfriend steals $50,000 from the bank, then come talk to me about puppies and ice cream? Is it because I'm afraid of real commitment? Do I think bastards are more exciting? Am I looking for someone like my father who bought mom a shotgun for Mother's Day? Who cares? Gentlemen, you want to take me out for a nice romantic dinner? Make it Arby's and I'll melt. Score extra points if you forgot your wallet at home. You buy me flowers, they better be plastic or dead. Get me chocolates, you're going to want to eat half of them before you get to my house. Forget my birthday and I will put out, because no one ever won me over by being a nice guy. You want a piece of this action? You better be prepared to leave me stranded in a bar in Phoenix where the bathrooms are labeled poles and holes. I just can't control myself around a motherfucker. You say smoking takes years off my life. I say that's just less boyfriends throughout my apartment while I'm at work. You say I'm gonna end up a spinster. Well, I've already started collecting the cats, so all you jerks out there, set your crosshairs on another target. And if you need me to explain this to you, call me later. We'll discuss it over drinks.
Glad you're Sheridan, y'all. Glad you're Sheridan. This is my man. It's always a pleasure and a joy to have this brother here. Please give it up for Mr. Bo Seal.
Compliment. Yo, I wanna be down too. I must be confused between lyrics like damn she's fly, high with chinky eyes, and chinky I could re-inspy. And if I buy, I don't understand the words. Why don't you teach me? Is there a word for the eyes of Puerto Ricans? Did white racists in the 1800s invent that word too? How were the words handed down? Are they used like this? At once you could hear the screaming jinx. Did someone else also turn your racial slurs into compliments on your behalf? Did you feel as empowered as I did, learning that non-chinks made chink okay for everyone else to say? I feel so ignorant. Yo, is it cool now to use racial slurs to talk about someone's physical features? Like, is that what's hip? Are there rock songs about N-word asses? Country songs about W back hair? Pop songs about a woman's rhymes with bike nose? I wanna know. I'm stupid. Up until 2 weeks ago, I thought most urban radio personalities were white. You know, because I figured anyone who had suffered at the hands of oppression, right, would never be insensitive to my mother's struggle. But forgive me, I'm sorry. I had no idea that we were at the dawn of a new age. Do you hear that, my white friends? Now you and your one black friend can recite 50s lyrics together. All minorities have stopped allowing the hegemony to pit us against one another. Every race issue has been resolved, my fellow chinks, formerly known as Asians. These offensive terms aren't ratings, aren't economic frustrations misguided, and William Hung is not a joke. So don't be offended. Don't fight for equal media representation. Don't boycott parent companies. Die. And don't ever argue when someone else tries to tell you about your experience. Because if you don't know, now you know.
LA, give it up for my man, Shehan.
If there's ever a time you can't find me, don't worry. I'm doing all right. I'm probably hiding out somewhere, counting my blessings, mumbling something about sunshine, wondering how much love I could live in a lifetime. See, I found my reason to live again, my daughter. And she has me conversing with Father Time, trying to convince him to allow me the ability to witness my future history. I'll grow my legacy, and I think it's working. See, he led me to her, my wife. And she is my fountain of youth, and I've drunk her to the point that I've been reborn, and I've seen the light. See, in the beginning, there was the Word. And the Word was with God, and that Word was her. And God took one of her ribs to create me. Now her one rib less was left with a shape, and I left shapeless. Now 1 + 1 = 1. Our bond cannot be broken. We consummated our commitment to each other and created our first child. Now 1 + 1 = 3. And I know the math sounds strange, and sometimes I find myself struggling with divinity, but why try? Mother, father, child is the Holy Trinity, and she is living proof that there is truth in fertility, and we live a love that God would envy. And for her, I would carry the cross for my own crucifixion if it make her have more faith in me. And I could hang from that cross and you could pierce my side with the spear and I would just bleed more reasons to love her. And I could die on that cross and you could bury me in a tomb and I would rise on the 23rd hour just to prove that I cannot live a day without her. And I would go toe with the eternity for the rights to her next lifetime because I was the only one made for her. And some may question the love that we share, but it only makes me question their faith. So I ask you, what else do I have to prove?
Our next poet and professor has published numerous books, ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Sonia Sanchez.
Our vision is our voice. We cut through the country where madmen goose-step in tune to Guernica. We are people made of fire. We walk with ceremonial breaths. We have condemned talking mouths. We run without legs. We see without eyes. Loud laughter breaks over our heads. Give me courage so I can spread it over my face and mouth. We are secret rivers with shaking hips and crests. Come awake in our thunder so that our eyes can see behind trees. For the world is split wide open and you hide your hands behind your backs. For the world is broken into little pieces and you beg with 10 cups for life. Are we not more than hunger and music? Are we not more than harlequins and horns? Are we not more than color and drums? Are we not more than anger and dance? Give me courage so I can spread it over my face and mouth. We are the Shakers, walking from top to bottom in a day. We are like Shango, involving ourselves in acts that bring life to the middle of our stomachs. We are coming towards you, madmen, shredding your death talk, standing in front with mournings around our waist. We have inherited our prayers from the rain, our eyes from the children of Soweto. Red rain pours over the land and our fire mixes with the water. Give me courage, give me courage, give me courage, give me courage so I can spread it over my face and mouth. Give me courage, give me courage, give me courage so I can spread it over my face and mouth. That's what we all need, courage. We need courage.
From Rochester, New York, by way of Atlanta, Georgia, please give it up for my brother, Amir Suleiman.
She said that she would prefer a broken neck to another broken heart. And I said, remember, even the beauty of birth leaves its own scars, and know that you will find your home right where you are. She said, I know it sounds cliche, but I really am just waiting to exhale. She's not looking for the perfect man. She ain't holding out for Denzel. She's just looking for a real man. But she said most of the realists wouldn't graze her in jail. Just an upright brother, but she's left with low-down brothers, homo thugs, and down-low brothers. And it took her some time with herself to discover that having love is even more important than having a lover. But what am I supposed to tell her? That it's gonna be okay, but it may not be. It may be hard and ugly, difficult, complicated, rough and bloody. And I said, so many women are struggling. She said, yeah, I'd like a man to kiss me. I'd like a man to hug me, but he's gotta truly love love before he can truly love me. And I said, I feel you. She said, no, you're not feeling me. We are women bringing up seeds. Our own sons grow up thinking love is a disease, ducking and dodging real relationships and just learn to take what they please. And they treat pregnancy like an STD. If the test comes back positive, it's a negative. And they are ghosts in the street, drought in the wind. Only a moment is spent and those moments are brief. Our sons' role models are Rolling Stones, unknown or deceased. They figure we can't teach them manhood so they get grown in the streets. So when it's cold world, they find warmth with men whole in the heat. I said, it's gotta be a change. She said, yeah, it's gonna have to be more than poems on TV. And I said, I feel you. She asked me how I survived. I said, by Allah, it was my mother. Otherwise, I would have been dead, crazy, institutionalized. She kept us in the good neighborhoods, even though she couldn't keep on the lights. So we could go to the best school, learning to read and to write. Sometimes we'd be so broke in the store, she had to pick between the beans and the rice. So sometimes she would put ketchup on a navy bean, so it wouldn't seem like we're eating the same thing every night. Two jobs during the day and one at night. And the struggle that I saw her endure, I never want to see my wife. So I know that being a man is more than being male, and I'm focused on doing it right. But when I think about my childhood, I don't think about poverty. I remember how she hugged me, kissed me, taught me, loved me, and I know you prefer a broken neck to another broken heart. Broken paws that litter the night sky like stars. But remember, even the beauty of birth leaves its own scars, and know that you will find your home right where you are. We will find our homes right where we are.
Give it up, brother. Amen. from the Bronx in Brooklyn, New York City. Please give it up for two of my favorites, man. My man Lemon and Flock on the Vibe.
To the Marias and Jose's, and this is for your place in rap history, even though we don't show face.
See, we've been around since before the underground.
King of the B-boys, you know how we used to freeze in the background.
Never had to worry about how can I be down, cause I'm New Eureka, man.
My people been here since
you can remember, man.
Internationally, no one gets it the way we get it on. My people are the true United Colors of Benetton.
Shit, I got a cousin named Chino with an Asian persuasion that'll have you fooled.
Reparations for my grandmother, she's black enough to own her own 40 acres in a mule.
And a cousin so white,
but he still grew up listening to
Super Kaku.
We all the best dancers, but gangster, even about our salseros.
Well, Hector Lavoe's man better than Cheo Feliciano.
We're not just mira, mira, and pero, pero.
Our war stories are sincero. Read them in el vocero.
Put your hands on our women, she'll blow off your little webbles.
No other tribal ladies look better in stilettos.
But what's more beautiful is to see my sisters make it out the ghetto.
We are so blessed.
Our grandmothers cook a sancocho for the soul and they stew the bacon stretch.
While our grandfathers kill chickens in the projects. Brokey, there's nothing new to me.
That's why I put it down for the Capicu Kings in my community.
I'm representing Puerto Rock.
Reggaeton, hip-hop.
Trinidad won't stop with a left hook tan duro.
We even got the king of the boy bands, Menudo.
My people got a reputation that we party like we don't play.
We'll raid your baby shower and start a party in your hallway. Can I get a bye-ya to all the children of the barrios and playas? Bump your fists like this a little higher. Throw your politics in the bonfire. Cause to be Puerto Rican is to be fly.
But to be Boricua
is to be so much flyer.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
One thing I haven't said all week, I just want to say now, is that this would not happen without my brother Danny Simmons, who's up there right now. When poetry, when there's only finger snaps and head wraps and stuff like that, nah, he was like, check it out. I was like, So thank you, Danny, for bringing this. And thank you all for coming out tonight. God bless you. Good night.
Since no one really knows anything about God, those who think they do are just troublemakers. Rabia of Basra, deaf poet. Let's get it going.
I got a story to tell.
Ideas kiss similes so deeply.
Deaf poetry.
Your existence is fresh. Status quo.
I should come away.
And I was teaching.
My people is in the house.
Rock the empty machine of rock.
Russell Simmons presents Deaf Poetry.
Ladies and gentlemen, your host from the planet of Brooklyn, Mos Def. What up, New York? What's up, Queens is here, Harlem World is here, yeah. It's in the building. Long Island is here.
Chicago is here. Home team is here. What's up, Kay? What's up, Brooklyn? I'm glad to be in New York City, one of the greatest places on earth, for real. In Kansas City, Missouri, by way of Brooklyn, New York. Please give it up for Preach.
Looking at my Rolex, it's about that time. Dry clean my green guys, cause they cotton line. A label connoisseur, stay dressed to the nines. I'm cash sighted for small change, have to squint like blind. We built this shit here, we built this. Ankles locked and whipped, yeah, we built this shit. Shucking and a jiving and a cotton picking niggas. Back broke, sunstroke, neck stretch like a hard dick swinging from a rope, like a human wind chime. Kidnapped, raped, separated for a lifetime. Slavery was real and it still is, young bucks. The touch, the feel of cotton, it's the fabric of our lives. It's a new time. These are good years. We've arrived now, no oppression here. Look at us now, we all fashion plates, trendsetters. Number one consumers, no one does it better. Ballin', hustling, robbing just to get this cheddar. Herded up like livestock, living in high-rise boxes. Bentleys, Benzes, line of project parking lots. Sing a song of bling, bling, all the rappers sing. Jigga, Master P, Diddy, money ain't a thing. And we built this shit here, we built this. While the man's taxes shake our poor asses down and fatten the pockets of the rich. Balancing budgets on our backs and still we cotton pick. Oh yes, from store racks now instead of fields. And yes, capitalism kills. And America don't give a damn about the poor. No, not for real. Study cracking the whip on the oppressed masses while we work to death to pay the bills. No proper health care, no welfare, prisons in abundance everywhere as we build and build and build. Yeah, we built this shit. We built this shit. Dressed down, hiked out, still slaves. That's it. The touch, the feel of cotton. Shit. It's our lives.
Los Angeles, please give a warm up poetry welcome to Steve Connell and Sekou the Misfit.
We cannot avoid the politics of our existence.
And you know what I hate about that?
Choosing.
I'm not a very good chooser.
I just wish that somebody would choose for me. So all I have to use my voice to say is thank you
for making this easy.
And that's foul. That's foul.
I know,
you're wrong
but
for that.
I'm a mess. Oh, like in restaurants. I look at menus like I've never had food.
I hate that.
What do you think they mean by lettuce?
Okay.
What do you recommend? Mm-hmm. Oh, could you tell me again about the specials? What was that one with the sauce?
One more second.
And sometimes the choices, they're easy. Right. Like ribbed for her pleasure or ultra thin for his pleasure.
His pleasure,
that's right.
But sometimes it's not so easy. Like, stop and get a condom. Mm-hmm. Or don't stop and get a family. And if it ever gets to be too much, always understand this is America.
Right, you can't stop the phone from ringing, but you can turn the ringer off.
But if you do, you end up with a bunch of backed up messages that all deliver the same message.
Yo, dude, where you at? It's America.
Hello, it's America, dog. I suggest you pick up.
Yo, never heard back, so
while you are out,
I got us a new home security system that gives our home security from everyone except us.
I also took the liberty of taking your liberty. I'll let you know where it is when security clears you.
Yeah, and could you make sure you feed the bunnies in your grandma's room?
You know, you'd be surprised at how many endangered bunnies you can save by cutting her health care.
So, grandma's dead, but on the plus side,
bunnies! Which your daughter's gonna have time to take care of since I also cut her dance class.
Yeah, but don't you worry, cut you a big tax refund check.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
It ought to be just enough.
To cover the legal fees.
For that Lauryn Hill CD.
You download it online.
Anyway,
I gotta run.
Still gotta create a few jobs.
Purge a few voter lists.
Catch a few terrorists.
Before you wake up and start complaining about every choice you allow me to make on your behalf. So, hey, from the bottom of our hearts.
From your faithful government to you. Thank you
for making this easy.
Austin, Texas. Please, it's Warren Duff Poetry. Welcome to Big Papa E.
I imagine myself with you, my friend, on childhood street corners, sweating in the summertime sun, sucking on frozen Kool-Aid in a Dixie cup in the curbside shade of a broken-down pickup truck. I imagine us locking and popping to old-school hip-hop like Boogaloo Shrimp, trying to pimp the candy store hotties with our portable cardboard dance floors. We'd spin all gangly bodies into B-boy oblivion, fronting with some white kid cabbage patch running man mime shit, thinking I was the moonwalkingest motherfucker in all the neighborhood, and waiting for the end of the bidding war for our music. Sucker MCs could not fade us. We was lyrical assassinators, cold-cut commentators, gesticulating wildly over plates of your great-aunts, red beans and green tomatoes, collard greens and mashed potatoes. And I'm telling my friend about this dope poem I'm writing about him and me when we was kids. And I looked to him, expecting that glowing smile of recognition, expecting imagined stories to fall from his tongue like ripe plums. Stories populated with characters named Skillethead and Junebug, and prefacing everything with, man, you remember that one time? And I'd be like, yo, that shit was off the hook. But my friend doesn't smile. He just clucks his tongue at me. He says, now I appreciate the enthusiasm with which you embrace what you think is my culture. But I have news for you, my friend. My mother wasn't Wheezy Jefferson. And my father wasn't Fred Sanford. And I did not spend my childhood on street corners with Fat Albert and the Cosby Kids. You see, I don't appreciate you rewriting my childhood just so you could pretend you had a black friend. I've lost track of my white friends who think Negro is some esoteric language with secret handshakes and code words you can just pick up through osmosis, through the Beastie Boys and blaxploitation flicks. I mean, it's cool you know so much about Miles Davis and John Coltrane and Thelonious Monk, and it's cool you know so much about Etheridge Knight and Amiri Baraka and Maya Angelou, but that does not mean you know anything about me. Now go write a poem about that.
Please give a warm Duff Poetry welcome to Miss Amanda Diva.
Y'all good? Yeah. All right. I got 40 MCs on my block walking with a bop claiming that they real hip hop. 80 feet in Tim's and sagging jeans, rhyming about cream, chasing the same dream. This poem is a little ditty about the 40 MCs on what seems like every block in New York City. It's a pity most ain't rhyming for the love, it's for the fame. Treating this culture like it's a game. See, their mental state is getting minds when they script between the lines. They ain't worried about the rhyme, they just trying to make a dime. So in time, the hosts are pushing pens to get them arranged. Like milk past the date, go quickly down the drain. There was 40 MCs on my block, and 3 had kids. 1 got shot, 4 got knocked. 1 got with a chick that made him put his pad away. The other went back to school to get her BFA. Now, I'm a rapper, they all say, till their pockets ain't getting stuffed or their lives get a little rough. Man, that MC shit was just a bluff. Because when the going got tough, it didn't take much for the MCs to get hushed. So now there's 30 MCs on my block, holding down the cypher spot in front of the corner shop, 60 arms swinging as they frantically fold, feeding to spit some shit to make their poetry go, oh! But you know how it go. I'm that nigga, they all figure, wannabe jigger, screaming, soon I'll be making major figures. They start rhyming for the money because they think it's easy, but insincerity has no longevity, you feel me? Eventually, 3 got locked up, 4 got a weed spot and a 4-floor walk-up, 5 had kids, 2 got knocked up, 3 was living with their moms and forced to act like grown-ups, had to go get jobs, so they hung the mic up. 1 became a born-again Christian. And when cats ask him, yo, when you gonna rhyme again? He looks up and says, ask him. So now there's 10 MCs on my block. But the rest will be replaced before this show is done. Ready with their bullshit raps to rape this culture and run. Because there's so many fake MCs who are whack. About 40 on every block and every city to be exact. But rhyming words with nouns and verbs doesn't make you an MC. You gotta live for the funk and die for the funk. If you don't, put your pen down, please.
Boston, New York, please give it up for my man, I'll be back.
My skin can somehow allow me to see more cells than sand sea seashells. I can have the power to inject superhuman strength inside 2 generations ago. as she grips her purse tighter than she's ever gripped it before. I know that that was my doing. All minds and all eyes and all hope is on me in a room where a wallet is stolen. I can make you pick me for any sport. Before you found out that I'm just a poet with seven sisters. However, since you want me to play, how can I own myself? I am so mature that my face can rearrange in days, change in ways that cops every day need to stop me and see my ID. Just to make sure I am who I say I am. Except on job applications. Usually, my majestic self don't concern with rumors. However, ladies, it's true. I am not a Republican. Don't get surprised at a chant and dance in me because this is me. Cool to be your driver, but not your son-in-law, me. I can get you dead presidents as long as I never want to be one, me. Hang on rims, hang on trees, hang up on bill collectors, me. Chickens in fear bow when they see me. Surveillance cameras always make it their point to see me. Justin Timberlake still could never be me. And despite all that goes on around me, I just want arms to come around me and hold me, despite what you think I am.
From Atlanta, Georgia, please give it up for 19-year-old Sister Queen.
Okay. I've had some say, Sister Queen, try being a lady. Okay, bitch, I will if you promise to fucking pay me. Lady Lyko, you mean a dyke always ready to fight? Cause if you touch me, I might just fucking fight. Fuck it, I will. I got so much gutter being slung from my tongue. If it was 92 NWA, it would have appeared to be nuns. Cause I'd be spitting the reels of life and obvious puns. Pussy dudes lift weights, I'm a woman, I lift tons. Try being a lady? Oh, you mean you want me to act catty and shady? Play with me like a dog, degrade me, then trade me. Use me as your trophy so that you can parade me. Use my vagina to only birth babies. Be your damsel in distress so a brother can save me. How about not? Cause if my tongue was the trigger, you would have been shot. Get real, I'ma stay inappropriate till I fucking ride. I don't talk about love. I don't talk about sex. I don't talk about things that'll put your dick on a wreck. I won't pour you some tea. I won't bake you some cookies. I won't be your next Sierra singing about my goodies. I won't speak when I'm spoken to. How about I speak when I choose? I don't care if you're depressed, I'm gonna speak my views. I won't be what you want, I won't be what you ask. How about some of you ladies show your real face because I've already ripped off my mask. I won't cooperate with you. And the ones that do follow these rules, I pity these fools because evidently they stupid enough to drown themselves in kiddie pools because I'm a knuckle-popping, cock-blocking, dollar-stocking, ear-shocking, brain-rocking, using my time for the TikTok-ing, boot-knocking, word-stalking, crew-talking young lady. I'm gonna gut you up with triggerous words that'll make you shut up, leave you fucked up. Got dag-like tones that'll cut you up, turn your ass into confetti, leave you wrecked by my words machete. So go ahead and talk about how I need to contain myself. Shut up and sane myself. So if you mad now, I'm gonna piss you off till you sick. How about this? I'm gonna get a sex change operation so you and half of America can officially suck my dick. Hold up. Okay. Maybe I've been too much of a smart ass and gave too much lip to you. How about this? I'm gonna put my hand on my hip for you. Is this lady like enough for you? Fuck you. Cause see, none of this shit fades me. I just want you all to think of Sister Queen the next time you suggest the one to try being a damn lady. Thank you.
From New York by way of LA, please give it up for Sherry Quigley.
Three-part Bitter Ex-Girlfriend, poem number 167249B. Part one. How my front door got broken. As she fled from my apartment with her possessions and my heart, she slammed the front door, cracking that shit fully from top to bottom. And she said, I bet you'll stick that in a poem too, won't you, you sick fuck? She was right. Part two. Sorry about the rash. Look, I said I wanted to meet and get together with you and try to talk and kind of work things out. And you said that we should, and then you said that we shouldn't without you first checking with your chaperone. I'm sorry, I mean your therapist. Check it out. It's not like I report on your petty acts of torture from the stage or anything, or write them down and use them for my work or anything. You see, I'm really just a demented troubadour, but I really have moved on in many important and meaningful ways because I remembered how much I used to just love white chocolate. So I went out and I bought a big block of it and I put it in a pot and I melted it on the stove and I poured it over the voodoo doll likeness of you just in case you're wondering where you got that fucking rash from. Part three. I really want to get a dog. But I need a woman first. You see, a dog's love is so unconditional and magnificent that I'm afraid that if I get a dog before I get a woman, I'll turn into one of those animal freaks that have birthday parties for their dogs and all their dogs' doggy friends and make them wear party hats and then videotape that lunacy. And without a woman, I'll send home my dog. I'll call him like MC Junko. He'll have a fat gold chain with his name cast in like giant rough hewn gold letters, MC Junko. And we'll get a convertible right around with the top down. We roll to the park, I'll make him wear sunglasses. All the other dogs will be jealous and they'll say, oh shit, check out MC Junko, fat rhino, fat gold chain. And we'll sit at home watching the videotape of his birthday party becoming less and less attractive to women as we spend more and more time with each other. I definitely need a woman before I get a dog. Oh God, look at what I've been reduced to.
Give it up for old man Trey Quickly. This is our next guest's third time here, and it's always a pleasure to have him here. He's one of those cats, which means that there's no one quite like him. Ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor and a privilege to present Mr. Oscar Brown Jr.
Now, I've landed on this beach it takes 60-odd years to reach, as this generation of mine is ordered onto life's front line, the targets of a fusillade that forces us to think of God. Reluctantly, we storm this beach, advancing to fill up the breach created by that fallen core of elders who charged here before while we enjoyed our middle age, removed from fire we now engage. A withering barrage rakes this beach. Its bullets bear the names of each of those who set foot on these sands. Old General Calendar commands, advancing to a sure defeat without the option to retreat. We knew before we hit this beach, the enemy that we besiege has ammunition for us all. Who has casualties must fall. Not one will manage to survive. Nobody leaves this beach alive. For those arriving on this beach, there is no prayer to pray or preach to beg us off in any tongue, since we've outlived dying young and for surviving in exchange, now face the fire at point blank range. The witness we bear on this beach has only one lesson to teach. Here, the carnage never stops, as every day another drops, some classmate, relative, or friend whose attack comes to abrupt end. So, on into the breach, my peers. Who knows how many weeks or years remain till you and I are hit as we inch onward bit by bit. We only know our lives will bleach eternally out on this beach.
From Jamaica, by way of Brooklyn, New York, Miss Stacey Ann Shin.
So what shall I do now with
these causes I carry burning on the front lines of a foreign war. Can you see the cluster bombs with children's first names on them? The grandfathers, helpless and praying for peace. The snipers, gunning for targets never seen before. New York will never be the same again. And I will never really be American. But this fight will have to be mine. Long after it ends, we will remember the faces. Filmed out of focus, the names uncomfortable on our tongues, the mouths beneath the beards, the tears the women cried for the dead, the towers, the long hours of not knowing who had been at work that week, who had been fired the week before. This generation will remember everything. The smoke, the Taliban, the traffic jams, the politicians who used terror to buy votes, the notes to long-forgotten friends, the news that threatened the very worst in us. Even now, the religious rally for blood. Revenge is mine, saith the Lord. And I don't know if you really said that because I'm thinking Allah could be a girl. I wouldn't be surprised if she sometimes crept in my room with too many windows, takes up more than half my bed, reminds me to laugh at myself. God of small things. She shows me my life's work in these causes I carry from state to state. She holds me on the nights I cry more than I eat, sleep less than I should. God of all things, she sees this fear that threatens my silence. And still she gently asks, if we do not tell these stories, who will?
Who's the man in excellence? Brother Jay, ladies and gentlemen.
Deep, sub-basement Atlantis, my level, as I pull up my guns and scoop the game with the shovel. Buffalo soldier, yippee-ki-yay, nigga. I float like a butterfly and sting like the Candyman rolling on a slave killer. I come deeper than the fact and the failures of our government. Parliament Square biz relived. I walk with an umbrella to avoid piss and jizz on my dome. Leaking through the breached ozone. Satellite cock block so I can't phone home. E.T. earthbound, my descendants on chrome. I gotta penetrate like my old nose bone and keep my rhymes in the zone. Hear me, wise domes, where we going with this? Soldiers with different stories still want the same shit? Freedom for our families. The calamity of street wars killing us softly. Jails are costly. Lies are priceless. The music is the message. The beast within spits the niceness. Based on the track, I'm the band to snatch. At the crossroads, holding it down. I'm haunting the whack. Return of the Mac. Coming forth by day. You see the lights getting bright around Brother Jay's way. Spellbinding. Coming with the just right timing. My super sperm cake got the liberation flag on the inside lining. Come as you are. Seeds of evolution still right from my law. Way live. I come in hiatus from the game. I took five. I'm like Michael Jordan sporting culture to the five. I'm in flight. It's like a Tyson fight when he was no socks and hungry, son. I'm wild for the night. For justice, I fight like Toussaint. My style is the limbo between backpackers and ice guards. From wax to ice, to wax to iPods. I translate the science beyond pop facade. My range way beyond any color you can fathom. I represent the youth that sincerely miss Tupac and elders that miss Malcolm. Dedicated to the movement. There's no dipping and dabbing. Freedom or death is not an option. What's happening with the frontline soldiers? We forget about the struggle so easy, we targets for takeover. Peace and love. I want to say one thing. Everybody put their fists in the air one time for me. In the ways of Malcolm X, in the ways of Marcus Garvey, in the ways of Sonny Carson, as my brother Professor X would say, vainglorious. This is protected by the red, the black, and the green with a key.
Give it up for Brother Jay, y'all. Yeah, absolutely. I'm glad he did that. Art is important in a society because when people start losing their imagination, then they could get bullied. It all starts with a dream. You know what I'm saying? You build the world that you're in. You can make the world that you're in. Ladies and gentlemen, Chicago Zone, Common.
Power to the people, y'all. Power to the people.
I'm gonna do this joint. It's called Be Known. Don't wanna be known for clothes that don't match. Wanna be known for what I did for blacks. And if I'm known as a pimp or a Mac, it's these rap niggas that I pimp slap. Known to interact with soldiers who only know attack. Get a little paper, I don't know how to act. Known to stay committed, but never attached. Said I'm the best to hit it. I'm even better with raps. Now I know in this game, you can't relax. No, y'all wanted resurrection, I came, I'm back. No, sometimes Mike wish he never came back. No, sometimes Mike wish he would have stayed black. Got more love for Oprah, now I know she gave back. A Chicago nigga, we known to be laid back. Brave, black, and beautiful. I'm also known to be, it's the C, y'all know it's me. Not knowing the future, I don't repeat the past. When I go, I wanna be known like El Hajj Malik Shabazz. I stash, I don't know how long this'll last. More money, more snakes in the grass. I don't know what it is with white girls getting ass. Oh, I know what it is, it's cash. I don't know why J-Lo moves so fast. I know it's in your blood for you to move your ass. I know most of us won't remove our masks. I know the truth, the news ain't gon' flash. I know it's a trend for people to bush bash. Hope it pop enough so the days of Bush pass. No, it's nothing in the world that I can't grasp, including Sanaa Lathan's beautiful ass. I'm looking. Brother Stan, no disrespect. Including Sanaa Lathan's beautiful ass. I'm looking through the glass, knowing it's a lot to touch. I know enough to know I don't know much. Peace, y'all. Come. Thank you.
Give it up for Colin. Oh, shit, it's Russell Simmons.
Yeah! Anyway, thank you all for sharing this evening with us. God bless you. Good night.
A good poem is like finding a hole in the palace wall. Never know what you might see. Tukaram, Deaf Poet. Let's get it going.
I got a story to tell.
Ideas kiss similes so deeply.
Deaf poetry.
Your existence is fresh. Status quo.
I just got my wings.
My people's in the house.
Rock the empty pursuit of props.
Pharmaceutical schemes.
Somebody's got to hear my story.
Give it up, give it up. Give it
Russell
up.
Simmons presents Deaf Poetry. Poetry.
Ladies and gentlemen, your host from the planet of Brooklyn, Mos Def.
What up? Y'all ready to have some fun? Y'all ready? Y'all good? Y'all look good. And, we got a fantastic show for y'all this evening. Some of the people here tonight have beautiful people with raw thoughts. You got raw people with beautiful thoughts. But all of it is going to be real, and I'm sure all of you will connect with someone or something that you experienced here tonight, and we're all glad to have you. New York City, welcome to Deaf Poetry. Let's get it going. From Brooklyn, by way of Palestine, please
Show your love for deaf poet Suher Homan.
Mike checked my bags at the airport. In a random routine check, I understand, Mike. I do. You too were altered that day. And most days, most folks operate on fear, often hate. This is my check, your job. And I am always random. I understand. It was folks who looked, smelled, maybe prayed like me. Can you hear me, Mike? Red-cheeked with blonde buzz cut, cornflower eyes, and a cross round your neck, Mike, check. Folks who looked like you stank so bad the Indians smelled them before they landed. They murdered 1212 as they prayed. Spread smallpox as alms. Mike, check, yes. I packed my own bags. Can you hear me? No, they have not been out of my possession. Thanks, Mike. You have a good day, 212. Check, Mike, check, Mike. Ayo, Mike, who's gonna check you?
Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm good poetry welcome to my man Lemon.
This is to the generation born without a choice. Born more broker than broke, more ghetto than ghetto. This wants to let the world hear your voice. Cause there's too many nowadays claiming hardship when they grew up in a hood with a family full of love. And only the real struggle is known that just cause you're from the projects, don't make you a thug. See, there's a difference between being ghetto and being poor. There's a difference between financial problems and being dead broke with nothing to live for. And when the ghetto wore suede Pumas and shell top Adidas, they made fun of the poor for wearing Payless with four stripes and called them shits Faritas. See, the ghetto could take a bite out of a full course meal and just throw the rest away. The poor eat white rice with eggs and ketchup and consider that gourmet. So next time you see a young man with a criminal record trying to get a job, hook a brother up, because that's the truth behind why he sells crack and why your ass got robbed. Next time you laugh at your homie still hanging on the street, remember that's who made you who you are, the reason why you eat. Never forget the grip, the grind, the hard times, the dirt. Always remember the poor people, even though it makes your heart hurt. Remember the poor people, and I'm not trying to tell you how to live, but vanity will kill you, so will MTV Cribs. Remember mainstream ghetto, and that's how you've been blessed. Remember that same God who blessed you always got a pocket filled with Generation Next. Next up to bat, next up to sharpen our raps, next up to take it all and run, next up to preach the science hard and keep it bouncing on the one. So believe me when I tell you, your money's not the root of all evil, because you will see pure hell coming when you forget about the poor people.
From West Covina, California, please welcome the Tamara Blue.
This is for the thick chicks. The 150 plus chicks. For the girls who have accepted their bellies and embraced them like fuck it, just love it. The girls who know that no matter how much they try, trim spa metabolite ain't gonna change these thighs. Believe me, I've tried. 36, 29, 42. 36, 29, 42, size 16, depending on the jeans. But this is for those girls who go out to eat late at night after spots, even though they're not hungry. They're just going for the company. But they understand that it's hard to maintain a figure like this, so they order the vanilla shake with the caramel twist, and please, can you make mine extra thick? So this is for being called thick. This is for the girls who know that being called thick is a compliment. This is for the average woman in America because she wears a size 12 or a 14, not a 6 or an 8. 6 and 8, those are shoe sizes. Those are not dress sizes. 36, 29, 42. Say it with me. 36, 29, 42, 169 pounds at 5'3". But grown men quiver when they look at me. So this is for the real reason that velour came back into style. For Big Les, Serena, Beyonce, and Trina. For the Tip Drill video on BET. For St. Louis, Atlanta, North Carolina, and Northern Cali, because they respect the booty. And the thickness. See, this is for the thickness, and this is for those jeans, those size 14s, and the girl who put on those size 14s and stepped out feeling fly. You see, this is for feeling fly and loving life. This is for feeling fly, loving life, but still allowing yourself to have some French fries, because this is for the thick chicks, the 150-plus chicks, the 36, 29, 42, 169 pounds at 5'3", size 16, depending on the jeans.
Los Angeles, please give a warm Poetry welcome to Beach.
Word is whoppered. Stage is stoppage. People are poppy popple. Microphone would be mopi croppa foppone. We loved it. Me and my sister, our secret language, like little poet laureates. And on weekends, the carpet would turn into lava, and we had to leap from furniture to furniture, calling out the names of things like an incantation. The cat. Copet, the dog, Dopog, the television set, Top-a-lop-a-vop-a-shop-and-sop-it. And if you didn't say it right, you would boil in the molten lop a vop a ah! We needed each other like magnets, because that's when our folks split up, and our dad remarried right away, so we got a brand new step-mop-om, and she was kind of a bop-itch, and... There were other problems that only going away to college could solve, and that's when I'd get answering machine messages like, hey, stop a wop warm, bop it, hop it, you know, stay warm, butthead, and dop on gop it, gop a nop a rop yop it, don't get gonorrhea. And my roommates would ask, what the fuck is that? And I would say what every American seems to like to say. I'd go, oh, well, my family is part Cherokee. So, the rest of the poem is none of your business. It was a Valentine's gift for my sister in February, but I will say that she and I don't talk much anymore, and I'm not sure why. Maybe her husband got drunk one night and accidentally ate part of our relationship. But I'm lucky, I guess. I still have the number of the very first person I ever adored, so when I call her up and try to make her laugh so hard that she forgets about the mortgage and the wrinkles and the weight gain and the other silly symptoms of us not being children anymore, when I tell her simple, sentimental things like, hey, listen, butthead, oppa lop of yapu. I know, even if my nephew's cartoon is kicking like mad in the background, that this woman is going to speak my language. Thank you.
Los Angeles, please give a warm death course and welcome to OTEP.
You have 7 more seconds to decipher your life before my tongue becomes a blade and your brain gets sliced. I warned you before, I'm addicted to war. I was praying for Armageddon on the day I was born. 3 pounds. 4 ounces. 7 weeks premature. Perfectly flawed. And perfectly impure. See, it was a night of lies. It was a sick, quick compromise. It was the devil in his eyes. It was innocence slithering down her thighs. It was his fucking fist into her fucking side. And why? Because there was a baby. Barely 3 months alive, but I survived. Too stubborn to succumb to the dripping jaws of the dominant paradigm. I speak out of turn. I taught myself everything that I ever needed to learn, which is, I don't have to be anything but me. Napalm bright, celebrating the burn. See, I'm supposed to be weak and depleted, my uniqueness erased and deleted. I'm supposed to be a fist and a bruise. Nothing left inside and nothing left to lose. They want me to be a breeder, not a thinker, not a leader, a sermonless disciple to a desperate, demented preacher. No voice, no choice. but I will fail them. I have no need for their acceptance, their limits, their lies. I learned to hate from you. I am your most beloved, blasphemous child. Thank you.
Give it up for O-Tap, baby. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's so real. Word. My pops used to say, if there was a town square and people could throw all of their problems in the middle, that you would take yours back and get another set. His brother sold thousands of copies of his novel, A Hip-Hop Story, on the subway, and that certainly made publishers pay attention. Now he's here to make you pay attention, New York. New York City, please give a warm Deaf Poetry welcome to Haru Patel.
Remember always that the answer you seek is a question. The question, it seemed, had always been with me. Why am I here? Why do I exist? Why is there life and why is there death? Why is everyone always looking at the glass as being half full or empty instead of just what it is? Half. And now, why is it that we have a problem when adults have their fuckery when they're just being adulterous? And isn't adultery that which adults do? As such, why do we keep making marriages monogamous? I mean, it's monotonous and illogical. And if not, then why is it there are far more women in this world than there are men, yet every woman expects every man to have just one woman? That's bad math and a bit selfish. Yet given this logic, why is it a woman will get with a man who already has another, encourages him to leave his woman, and expects him to be faithful to her? Oh, but I am being faithful, faithful to myself. I've always been this way. And even more eerie, why are there some who call themselves atheists when just to say you don't believe in God, you have to acknowledge that there is a God not to believe in? And now, why do we believe in God and believe that we can actually do something against his will, like have an abortion or commit suicide? And if God created everything and is everywhere, why is God in church and not the brothel? And if God is in both, why do I have to go to church? I mean, given I'm not a Christian, but why do Christians keep telling me that I'm being led astray? Telling me that I need to find Jesus. As if Jesus were lost. And now, if Jesus is lost, why the hell is everybody following him? I mean, so like, why are we here? Why do we exist? We exist because of God. But why is God? Wait a minute. That's it. Why is God? It's not the question, but rather the question and the answer to everything. Why is God? It is the universal equation, and I have solved it. And now, finally, there are no more damn questions.
Our next poet was once the New York State Poet Laureate, New York's own Sharon Olds.
Self-portrait. Rear view. Yeah. At first, I do not believe it in the hotel triple mirror that is my body, in back, below the waist, and above the legs, the thing that doesn't stop moving when I stop moving. And it doesn't look like just one thing, or even one big double thing. Even the word saddlebags has a smooth calfskin feel to it, compared to this compendium of net string bags shaking their booty of cellulite fruits and nuts. Some lumps look like bonbons translated intact from chocolate box to buttocks. The curl on top showing slightly through my skin. Once I see what I can do with this, I do it. High stepping to make the rapids of my bottom rush in ripples like a world wonder. Slowly, I believe what I am seeing. A 54-year-old rear end, once a tight end, high and mighty, almost a chicken butt, now exhausted, as if tragic. But this is not an invasion. My cul-de-sac is not being used to hatch alien cells, ball peens, gyroscopes, sacks of marbles. It's my hoard of treasure, my good luck, not to be dead yet. Though when I toss the mane of my ass again and see in a clutch of eggs, each egg on its own, as if shellless, shudder, I wonder if anyone has ever died looking in a mirror of horror. I think I will not even catch a cold from it. I will go to school to it, to butt boot camp, to the video store where I saw in the window my hero, my workout jelly role model, my apotheosis, killer buns.
Please welcome from Chicago, 17-year-old Perry Shelton.
She was never the beautiful, long-haired mother I wrote about in poems. She never walked barefoot through forest green blades of grass, sheared a perfect 2 inches, one blade at a time, carpeting the front lawn of her pink and white bungalow. She just wasn't that lucky. Sunflowers and rose bushes never draped across white picket fences. Her garden merely yielded curdled dandelions polka dotted across patches of brown. She learned to value their beauty because they had such pretty names, dandelions. However, she, my mother, still dreamt of sunny spring Saturdays, drenching her dreams with lemonade stands and sprinklers, heart-shaped bushes and glass Coke bottles, liberty and justice for all, but somehow she knew better than to dream too unsilently. As a child, she would fill my days with bologna sandwiches and flavored tap water. Then I never understood how hard she tried to keep me happy. And even up until today, I have yet to discover how often she dreams. But somehow I know that it's always about me and the husband she never had. She was never that medallion-shaped, apron-cloaked mistress moving proud across the wooden floor she dreamt of, wearing almost perfectly white socks, stretched disproportionate at the ankles from carrying life as pure as those damned white walls. She just wasn't that lucky, but today won't let her forget. Won't let her sink into an oblivion of white walls and pine floors, an oblivion of finely tuned but extremely rhythmless music, mother. Those dandelions are singing to you. Loud, boastful, brilliant, mother, those dandelions are beautiful like you, but like you, even they forget. Sorry they couldn't grow up amongst roses. Sorry, they sprang from the cracks etched in poverty America. They grew up amongst society's weeds. The neighborhood hates those dandelions. The neighborhood wants to kill those dandelions. But my mother always grows back to soak sun and hold it in her cheeks, then colored a bright, brilliant yellow. And that yellow-faced dandelion will never die, but she will always dream of something more than those weeds until the day she realizes that a flower as beautiful as her does not belong in a rose bush.
Representing the Queens, New York, give it up for my man, my brother, Consequence.
Man, I'm in a place that don't no man ever want to be. I'm in a place my homies like to call the friend zone. You see, I got me a homegirl that's real, real pretty, right? I can't hit it for nothing in the world. It really got to a point where I had to holler at her just say this to her. Now, girl, you must be hitting chronic or be on something beyond it. The thing is strictly platonic, is something sick and demonic. So when I see your number, I let the machine answer, because the only friends I need are Rachel, Ross, and Chandler. Because if I was really your dog, we would do it like dogs, instead of you getting dogged and asking why I'm in a dog's. So what am I, chopped liver? What is this, drop top sicker? What are you trying to tell me, that I'm not that nigga? Please. Well, not in so many words, because I see so many hers pulling up to your curb, because they done pay for your perm. Well, I done pay for your perm. All you had to do was x-ray. Man, but the only butt I would get is the one in the ashtray. Cause somehow she got it in her head that I ain't getting head. You know she had the nerve to keep a jacket on when she slept in my bed? It got me seeing red, cause she sees me like a brother and my ego can't recover, cause deep down I know I love her. At least I think I love her. Word. They say you might hit a star if you aim for the moon. I know she always get me hard when she walk in the room. That's cause she walked in the nude, just a t-shirt and her panties. And after three kids, she still fly like Manny. Made me her Mr. Nanny, gave me an instant family, buying her infants candy and using me as a plan B. And we both know we can't be alone, but we can't seem to bone cause we in the friend zone. Which means I'm in a buddy system, so she can't forget we buzz. It would take some weed buzz and at least three buds. So she could blame the drugs when she stopped seeing Bud and start seeing Stud when she see me in the club. And give me crazy love and let me cop a feel. Cause since I got my record deal, they call me Cocker Phil. No more Dr. Phil. That's not my feel. So if you're not trying to bend, then I'm not your friend.
From Dallas, Texas, please give a warm, warm Death Poetry welcome, Mr. Jason Carney.
Our soldiers, patriotic and valiant, in the name of lucrative soundbite liberty, they're dying. Like Korea, like Vietnam. But quick cash military actions are never won. They just become unprofitable, a spit on memory, folded in the triangular form of a flag like coffins could ever be proud, swallowed by dirt, grasping white crosses, heroic, but without freedom. Like American neighborhoods, sold to gun companies and privately held correctional genocide turned the wheels of viable poverty. Slave ships resurrected from emancipated splinters. You can't own flesh, but you can the drugs that control it. Harvest war like Afghanistan. A blossom of victory in ancient fields, now nurturing four-fifths of the world's opium. Fragrant like ambush, we flexed our muscles in the name of lucrative soundbite liberty, like what bombs do to families. And the enhanced lives of Afghani children must taste like prosperity, vomited from the leprous lips of stateside junkies. As death doubles as happiness here, America's an elusive propaganda of faith, broken up, bagged, and sold for $5. While the deaths of democracy's heroic martyrs are consecrated by companies amassing legal wealth from the illegal use of drugs like speed pipes disguised as ornamental vases and crack tubes stuffed with flowers or cannibalistic free enterprise trophies dwelling in corner stores saturating neighborhoods where most folks ain't got enough money to dream. God overwhelmed by all the freedom going on, blessing America. More dead heroes and more reservists to take the place. Long live a tax-free inheritance trade empire, faithless without despair, constructed on the degenerated bones of freedom. Like senior citizens strangling on Social Security at the vicious hands of their prosperous children, our soldiers are dying for freedom. Like public schools that can't afford luxuries such as books amid the high cost of metal detectors, our soldiers are dying for freedom. Like pharmaceutical companies that turned your doctors into free sample pushers, our soldiers are dying for freedom. Like Halliburton builds pipelines on the heads of corpseless contractors. Our soldiers are dying for freedom. Dying in the name of God like hysteria. A lucrative soundbite liberty. A spit on memory. Folded in the triangular form of a flag like coffins could ever be proud. Swallowed by dirt. Grasping white crosses. Heroic. But without freedom. Thank y'all.
Ladies and gentlemen, my friend, man with the most fantastic and realest name in hip hop, Black Thought. All right. Yeah. Guess I was struck by the luck of the draw. Real life preservation is what I'm hustling for. My name is Black Thought, the definition of raw. I was born in South Philly on a cement floor. We had nothing at all. I had the knuckle and brawl. They swore I'd fall or be another brick in the wall. Another life full of love that's lost. But that's silly. Come on, really. You know you're not stopping the ball with the pen. I'm like Willie on top of the hall. Pure soul is what my city's most popular for. Hear the tones that are easier, smooth as Bunny Siegler's soundtrack that keep your head bopping at all. Yeah, something in the water though where I come from. I used to sing it on the corner, yo, where I come from. Making something out of nothing because everybody's 50 cent away from a quarter though where I come from. Yo, the streets ain't timid, but I feel at home in it. Gotta see a couple people, I ain't got it in a minute. Yeah, you could take a brother out of South Philly, can't take him out of Philly, I forever represent. Home sweet home, the part of town where shots get sprayed around. The expectancy rate be 28 around downtown battleground. Cops parade around, have your whole view on life beyond jaded. How everybody sick of breaking down, trying
trying to make it out. Hand over fist, the only way to get their paper down. People sick of getting pushed around, getting gangster now. Discipline, the only way to bring some type of change about. Chain cigarette smoke heads with bad nerves and old men in barbershops using bad words. Whoever in the dark that's unseen and heard, let's emerge. I don't care if you this, that, and the third. To my street sweepers, hotel housekeepers, to my people spilling this out through jailhouse speakers. Some people rather lose their life than lose freedom. Some people rather choose to fight than get beaten. I'm blacked off in the roof.
Yo, give it up for Black Thought. Simple and plain, easy, fresh. I love that dude, man. That guy is amazing, man. It gets no realer than Black Thought. Did y'all, are y'all having a good time? Y'all had a good time? I just want to say it is always a pleasure and honor to be here with this show. Oh, shit, it's Russell Simmons.
Hey, man, what's up?
This was a good one, right? Thank y'all for coming and sharing with us. God bless you.
Back wings of the hospital where nothing will grow lie cinders in which shine the broken pieces of a green bottle. William Carlos Williams, deaf poet. Let's get it going.
I got a story to tell.
Ideas kiss similes so deeply.
Deaf poetry.
Your existence is fresh. Status quo.
I just got my wings.
And I was searching.
My people is in the house.
Rock.
Russell Simmons presents Deaf Poetry.
New York City, please make some noise for Deaf Poetry and your host, Mos Def.
What's up, New York?
Bang. And it weighs a ton. Here's the warm happiness in your favorite gun to run. They holler black, he that amazing one. I'm like, nah, martial art, I'm that amazing on this gym. Near before me, near after, near another. Beside my daughters, my son, my pappy, and my mama. And yeah, we in possession of genes for melanin. But me and other rappers bear zero resemblance. I'm on the terra firma and the fly, the cherubims. It ain't enough ink for the press to measure him. My pounds per square inch of the pressure to perish him. Niggas tryna act like I ain't been telling them dope. Knock it off. I've been clear for years. Maybe all that ice is numbing up your ears, and you can hear the boogeyman creeping up the stairs. Bang, surprise niggas, I was already there. Cat kaboom, it's the dude, super sniper upon the roof. I separate the lie from the truth. Man, forget cool. Turn a blind eye to the proof. Jump a mojo on the earth and make them feel it in their boots. Roots, culture, ghetto gangster magic. Brooklyn and NY division. Give it up for my man Minnesota on the beach. It was once said that poetry is nothing more than a quiet thought expressed at full volume. And here on Deaf Poetry, we like to express these thoughts at a clear and fresh present volume. Welcome, let's get ready. Y'all ready, New York City?
It's
from Los Angeles, California. Please give it up for the lovely and talented Miss Gina Lauren.
You move me. Like 14 years old, the autobiography of Malcolm X changed my life. Roots, age 19. You move me like a long, cool drink of water after the steepest hike on the hottest day, like Lena Horne's Grace and Alice Walker's Words and Billie Holiday's Life. Like the time I met Mr. T. Flinging myself into his arms like a little girl at 22, overcome with an emotion I did not realize I had. You see, we of the fatherless tribe love men differently. Like I love Mr. T. Sherman Hemsley, Bill Cosby, and Arsenio. Yes, Arsenio. Because they were constants for at least a period of time present in my home, in my living room, in my adolescence as no other men were, so I love them. Mr. T, that is how you move me, like humility, lessons, joy, grief, daydreams, truth. Because I am a Leo. So I walk with my head high and act like I'm cool, but really, I am scared. And you are the constellation that guides me home, the star that lights my path. Remind me of love and hope and action and dignity. Like Muhammad Ali, we will stand for something, and I am sensitive. And not a morning person. And nitpicky about lint. And sometimes too emotional, and other times not emotional enough because my youth was bruised, and you massaged me back to life with your rhythm, your words, your spirit. You move me like wind, like 5 years old. Rabbi Neil strums the guitar, familiar. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your might. I pretend to read from the prayer book. I can't really read yet, but I pray real. Like 20 years old, meeting my brother for the first time. My smile on his face, my eyes looking into my eyes, and so much pain behind both our eyes that I had to look away. You moved me like 1984 Olympics. Rafer Johnson was my hero, and every man in my life will forever be compared to him because he used to put me on his shoulders and I was special. If only every now and then you moved me like Native American prayer songs, like graffiti under freeways and jeans that fit perfectly, like hip hop, like Ella Fitzgerald's got amazing Azure blues, up and down and slipping sideways, harmonizing honey hymns. You moved me like sunshine, like you. Fred Hampton speaks truth, stands solid, thunder in the sky, rock the world, shock them, shake them, make them see, without a doubt, you most definitely move me.
From Dallas, by way of Hattiesburg, Mississippi, please give it up for Rock Lady.
Now, I've gotten busy with a skinny woman, and I gotta say that it was all right. Say all right.
All right.
And I've gotten busy with a medium-sized woman, and oh, yeah, it was tight. Say tight.
Tight.
But when I made love to a four-figured woman, that's when I realized I done got hold to me something. Maybe a bit more than I could handle, but hell, it's all good. Instead of searching for that junk in the trunk, I know now it's all about what's under the hood. Crocodile tears filled my eyes after that woman got through putting her loving all on me. I was thinking thoughts like, baby, don't go. Baby, don't leave. I'll do anything. I'll drink your bath water. Hell, I'll have your babies. Because ain't nobody ever been able to satisfy my Jones the way it's been satisfied by a woman with some meat on her bones. Homegrown, mama made, sweet and thick like syrup, making it difficult to be pleased by a smaller woman with just Kool-Aid. Now, I know most men won't get with a woman unless she's shaped like a Coke bottle and they know who they are. But me, when I'm hot and thirsty, I don't mind getting my refreshments from a jelly jar. Because at one time, I used to think that a certain-sized woman was just too thick for me. But now, when I see a full-figured woman, all I'm thinking is rotisserie. Big old juicy breasts with lusciously thick, creamy milk, buttery rolls, dimples, and thighs. I know most men only want happy meals of a woman, but I like my loving super-sized. Jumbo, chunky, rotund, plump, or swole. Big girl with me is on. Wear your thong, because I love dimples and rolls. And I would pay top dollar to see a big girl go for what you know. Instead of singing, shake it fast, I'd be singing, work it real slow. Yay, yay, big lady. Give it to me, baby. You don't have to fake it. Because I appreciate it. Hey, big lady. Do your thing, baby. Potato, steak, and gravy. Let me be your buffet, baby.
From Oakland, California. Please give a warm, cordial welcome to Shanaka Hodge.
In Oakland, the city of my birth, we don't say done. We don't say God. We don't say ma. We don't say earth. I called you cousin. Since 3 and 4, we've been tandem redbone. You guitar to my milkman. You Sealy to my Nettie. 8 and 9 when we burned our knee on the iron. 11 and 12 when we got our first boyfriends. 17 when you told me you'd left those alone. Cool. Then suddenly you were gone. Ghost, no trace, went to harvest your limbs from the ripening July wind, and sometimes I hear news of you that flutters there, that aches like your senior year and the men who did not know how to hold female, inducing the sound of your younger sister's snapping collarbone. These all tears we flung at the ceiling in the dark from the loft bed as we struggled for slumber. Today, you are finally old enough to cop your own liquor, and I wonder of your body. Does it move? Will it atrophy? Do you rust in your creases? Does your skin crust around you like that of a shriveling grape? Have you memorized the sound of saliva settling on your girl's tongue? Did she leave you for dead anyway? It's been 2 years since we've spoken, and the world is in the business of composting brown bodies, rotting, naked, we thumbs up, hysterical. They found Royville, age 55, swinging from his neck down from a branch down in Mississippi not a month ago, and everybody knows somebody they ain't seen in a while, just a little strung out. I swore to my boy Kadir on the corner of 16th and Linden I wouldn't watch motherfuckers just hang, kick it, get swerved at the side shows on Friday nights and never know what it's like when God goes finger painting and spring orgasms out of snow and salt in Jersey. Glad you made it around the sun again, but this time you really gotta run up on it. Hit the moon with brass knuckles, make that dry, sapping sound your anthem till you are old, shriveled, smiling, drenched in sweat, and leave this world with everything, with everything, with everything, and nothing but what you are due.
In Tree City, please give it up for my man, Dennis and Kane.
Don't bring my body home draped in a flag. Fuck a draft, fuck a war, fuck a patriot act. Sorry am I being out of line or course. When the powers up high lie as a matter of course. The dead will live again, but the wicked meet again. The father kept you safe though you didn't see it then. Joe, you be straight even though the road bend. Protect your soul, stay true to the end. I wet the wicked with the fluid in the pen. I shut the window on the devil's right hand. I spun the record till the table can't stand. Children in the alley eating up the master plan. Devils used to rock the white sheet to hide their sin. They engineer elections telling us to count again. Stop the count, start a war before the count end. Meanwhile, I'm scratching hard enough to break the damn skin. Wondering if the God they're claiming came down again. He get crucified the same and broadcast on television. Their rituals of pain and blame ain't religion. The Lord could walk among them and they still wouldn't listen. Don't bring my body home draped in a flag. Fuck a draft, fuck a war, fuck a patriot act. Sorry am I being out of line or course. When the powers up high lie as a matter of course. I'm still living in the woods alone till the lights down low. Girl, bend down low. Let me catch a fire, tell you what I know. When I plant my seed, baby doll, let it grow. Pop a cop, but I don't cop a plea. Shoot down chef, not a deputy. Burning, looting, bound to happen. Can't stop this evolution. Burning, looting, bound to happen. Can't stop this revolution. Mother of harlots, your kingdom is falling. Mask on, crumbling, your children go crawling. Calling for the mountaintop to tumble down and cover them. How will they find mercy when they had none for their brethren? Don't bring my body home draped in a flag. Fuck a draft, fuck a war, fuck a patriot act. Sorry am I being out of line or of course. But the powers up high lie as a matter of course. Of course. Peace out.
Give it up for Dennis and Kane, y'all. Our next guest is a veteran of the Black Arts Movement, a college professor, all-around dynamite individual. It's precisely what the show Deaf Poetry is about. It's always a pleasure to have him here. Please give a warm Deaf Poetry welcome to Harlem Zone, Mr. Sekou Sundiata.
Hey,
a dream for Aman, my grandson. I'm talking to a boy who is trying to master the art of staying awake, balancing the hard facts of daily living against a smooth, cloudless mind in the making. I can tell by the way he suddenly laughs in his sleep and signifies his descent into the kingdom of myth, where the world is forming behind his eyes. He points at me and calls me bird, snow, rain. I tell him I heard that half the species of birds in America migrate to the city, that the egrets and ibises favor the water around Rikers Island, that the woodcocks are knocking boots in the Bronx. It's a whole way of life. I try to be up front with the boy, so I admit that I never saw the birds coming. Aside from a few jittery sparrows, I always thought the pigeon should be our official bird, for the way it shits on the good and the bad and the people sitting on the fence. Anyway, I say, the birds probably came here for the same reasons as his great-grandparents, for the nest and the work, for the food and the culture. When we go to the park, he will call out sponge for sky and make the sound of sucking wind backwards through a straw to say traffic. I will tell him what it was like when he was born. There were so many mornings we awoke to the blessed silence of snow falling on snow. And there were cold rains that rained on days when the snow couldn't make it, like that one faithful soprano that shows up over the palisades and sits in for the whole galaxy when the moon's period is late and holding back. And now the drought has choked the grass back to dust, and we will have to save water this summer. Yet just below the dry dirt surface, the soil is still moist from winter. The garlic in backyard Brooklyn is growing well. There are reports that the Samarises have come to root. When he falls asleep in the stroller, I will put headphones over his ears and play Monk while he dozes, hoping he will dream in ascending intervals and practice his first steps, walking unfettered in the space of slumber. I will talk to him over the music. Listen, son, I can't tell one tree from another. I'm only telling you what I heard. I don't know how the winter snow and rain knew to go deep into the soil and drain out slowly because the following spring would be dry. And I don't know how those birds know exactly what to do. There is nothing in me to match that. But I do know this native tongue you speak, in which saying is believing. So I tell you now that the earth is made of matter, but the world is made of words. He points at me again and calls me blue.
To Chicago, we meet up for 18-year-old Christiana Colon.
The man who knelt under the span of Isabella's scepter was not called Christopher. The man who rolled the sea-splitting hull of La Santa Maria was not called Columbus. Cristobal. Cristobal Colon. A name my island did not know before 1492. Senor, you and your men plundered the wombs of my Taina ancestors, opened wide my island's ports for the trade of my African grandmothers, same as you opened her soil brown legs, trading her hymen for a new surname. You are the alchemist that mixed these three bloods, senor, and now I am here, Christiana Colon. When rain falls on the ashes of conquest, God molds a new people from the clay. I would love to hate you, senor, for the pillage of my island's virgin villages. I would love to hate you, Senor Colon, for having bent the backs of Africa's warriors over sugarcane fields. I would love to hate you, Conquistador Colon, but without you, there would be no me, no Boricua, no Central Park, Harlem, Bronx, beating with salsa rhythms in the red apple heart of New York, no metal flags arching over avenues, no Chicago summer swelling with the voices of the island's children waving that three-blooded banner over their heads. I grimace every year when this nation pauses in your honor, but without the blood of my uncles on your sword, dripping from the palm trees, congealing on the hot sand, without you forced into my grandmother's, there would be no me. I would love to hate you, abuelo, but without you, I have no name. Rape propels civilization forward. We all bear the names of men who held knives to the throats of our fathers. I would love to despise those who cut the tongues of the nameless generations that span my history, but I was born under the veil of their sins and to be the descendants of murderers. And those murdered can only teach compassion, so instead I will say thank you.
dig my fingers into the sand and soil that soaked the blood of my fallen fathers and extract my roots like conch shells or yams. I cannot hate you, Señor. I'm grateful to be alive.
From Berkeley, California, please give it up for Mr. Jimmy Tran.
Hi. My name is Jimmy Thong Tran, and I have a mediocre penis. Not too small to fit Asian American male stereotypes, not too big to break them. But like the last bowl of warm porridge, just right. The thing about us just right, guys, that we are the underdogs, and underdogs work the hardest. Hence, we are never deterred or scared. Always willing to do what the men with bigger penises aren't willing to do. My middle name is Thong. And you know where I'm going with that. Honey, I don't care if you have small anything. I have a big heart, so I will suck the shit out of your nipples. Fiercely gnaw on all your ass cheeks until you shake it like a salt shaker. And let's set the record straight. We Vietnamese men don't eat dog, we eat pussy. Because even though I have a mediocre penis, I write poetry so I can quiver your hips with my lips. I've run track so I can go the long mile. And I've studied gymnastics, and you know where I'm going. Well, that's one. So all you ladies who love mediocre penises, hurl me your digits. Throw your panties on stage. Prime your fantastic vaginas for a modest docking. Because my name is Jimmy Thong Tran. I have a mediocre penis. But even Goldilocks will tell you it's just right.
From Hunts Point, New York, please give it up for Jeff Ford, my man Flaco and Navaja.
Her dimple caught me out there. She didn't even need to smile. She just came over and asked me for a cigarette. Now, she looked a little young, so I asked her how old she was, like she shouldn't be smoking. She said 22. I was 19. I gave it a whole pack. And now, 6 years, 3 million arguments, and a couple of fuck you, I don't know what I'm doing with yous later, we're still here. Still in love. At least I am. Shit, I hope she is too, because if I'm writing this for her and she's not, that's fucked up, right? My lady could go from my best friend to my mother in one breath. She scolds me when I don't do the dishes, holds me when the world spits in my eye and when the words refuse to stick to the page. She brings me a cigarette, takes the pen and pad away, kisses my forehead and tells me it'll be okay. My lady, with her cute dimple, doesn't even need to smile. I can see the love in her eyes even when she's telling me to grow up, take life serious, pay the bills on time. She's quick to pull my card, but check herself when she's wrong. She's the Cheech to my Chong. Knew me before my hair was long, and I know I'm up here sounding like a sucker, but it took me 6 years, 3 million arguments, and a couple of fuck you, I don't know what I'm doing with yous, to learn how to appreciate her. My lady, with her cute dimple, doesn't even need to smile, but when she does, I see that I'm the richest man alive. And it's okay to be a sucker. Sometimes.
Please, welcome to the stage, Vagina Monologues, playwright and poet, is Eve Ensler.
I am leaving my father's house. Stepping out, stepping off, free falling outside the confines of what is acceptable and known. I am leaving this cage which suppressed me, depressed me, made less of me so thoroughly I came to call it my legacy, my country, my home. I am leaving those angry men whose broken hearts and wounds became more painful and urgent than my own. I'm not going to be sorry anymore or responsible or wrong. I'm going to stop believing I can wake you up or break open your shell or get you to feel your grief, your tenderness. I'm gonna stop mainlining my life force into your self-esteem. Air pump girl blowing up boy rubber ball. You can stay flat and go nowhere by yourself. I am leaving my father's house. I'm not gonna whisper anymore or tiptoeing or lay flat on my back. I'm not ducking, flinching, waiting till you finish or whimpering in the dark. I am moving out, I'm not going back. I am leaving my father's house. Because I no longer believe your lies about freedom and democracy, that it hurts you more than your whips or words or policies hurt me. I'm going to believe what I see. Bruises on my neck, Iraqi women with their voting fingers chopped off, emaciated polar bears in the Arctic melting from corporate greed. I'm fleeing your disguised terror of my bigness, my hunger, my vagina, my tongue. I am leaving my father's house. I don't want a position there. I'm not gonna leash your prisoners or jerk them off. I'm not gonna starve your workers, organize your lynch mobs, or camouflage your crimes. I'm not gonna be tits and ass on your arm or smile till my face breaks off. I am leaving my father's house. Corporate towers, cathedrals, mosques, and synagogues, picket fence houses and pentagons, I'm going out past the neighborhoods, past nations, fundamental doctrines and misinterpreted laws, past the reach of your fist, past the fire breath of your rage, past the tentacles of your seductive melancholy or your unspoken promises to change. I am willing to be alone, disliked, slandered, and misconstrued, because my freedom is more important than your so-called love. Because my leaping will be the ultimate jumping off, will be the new beginning where we all get to start. Without a daddy in charge, on top, in control of all the goods, ideas, interpretations, and cash, I'm going out there by myself. But I know I will find the rest of you there, waiting, ready, knee deep in the garden, hands raised in the water, way, way out past my father's house.
Give it up for Eve Hensley, y'all. It's a triple threat right here. It's three for the price of one. A cipher of rare dopeness. Please welcome by way of Philly, Muskegon, Michigan, and Los Angeles, Deaf Poets Black Ice Poetry and Shehan.
This is for the ladies.
We are men. We come in all shapes and sizes.
Some of us have a six-pack.
Some of us have my pack.
But that doesn't change the fact that we are men.
Make no mistake, what you hear when we step on stage are our balls banging.
They hang low.
So we can stay grounded.
We don't fly off the handle and let our emotions take control.
But I can't walk like I have ovaries.
What?
That don't make sense.
But it was funny when you wrote
it. Fuck it, quoted. We are men.
And if I don't say you are pretty every time you have on a new outfit...
It's because he already knows you're pretty.
And I thought I told you yesterday.
Oh, yeah. I can speak with heart and compassion.
But I'm that same guy that'd get real loud in front of family just when you thought everything was cool
Chill,
between
nigga,
us.
You know you can't debate her. Talk to her later.
With the lights out?
Oh, with the lights on?
Because I'm a freak with the lights on.
And no, I don't want you to say my name because I already know you know my name.
But I will do some shit to make you cock your head so far back you can watch your own ass shake.
Or make love to you nice and slow.
For hours.
Just the way you like it.
But sometimes, I just want to sleep.
We are men. And just because I'm in touch with the enemy, it doesn't mean you can try and stick your finger in my ass.
Sometimes I want to talk sports.
Play PlayStation with my boy.
But that doesn't make him any less of a man.
I'm just me.
A man who loves to live.
That's right. He's got a sensitive side to give. Drop that shit, man. Oh, man.
You know I love you more than I love myself sometimes. But I have a problem communicating. So what I'm trying to say is, let's talk about stuff.
And things.
And anything else that'll make you happy, I'll be there for you.
Just don't get mad if I pee on your leg when we're in the shower.
It's not because I was trying to be freaky. Nah.
I just don't want to wet the floor walking to the toilet.
Look, if there's some feminist fruit in here, we don't mean to spoil it.
Calm down.
Relax.
Take a breather.
We understand we wouldn't be nothing without y'all.
But y'all wouldn't be shit without us either.
temperature is high. Some good people here today, right? Oh, shit, it's Russell Simmons. It's Russell Simmons. Say so to the people.
Was that a beautiful show? I would. I mean, I'm so proud, you know, of all of these poets and what they're doing and how it affects young people. So thank you for coming and listening to them, and thank you. God bless.
Thank you.